is a day in the death of Tiny V. Strung out, waiting to die. Nothing to laugh at, no one to cry. Just another dirty gray day in the death of Dying B. Just another dirty gray day in the death of Dying B.
Just a waste of time.
Just to be normal, you have to go to a lot of hell.
It's like suicide, jumping off a bridge.
He's killing himself, and I have a sneaking suspicion that he knows it also.
This is one of the places where you become a junkie. This cold, narrow, steel barred cell. You'll see him in here, doubled up in pain, sweating it out, waiting for tomorrow.
I really didn't know who I was, where I was going. He assaulted me dead, mommy dead, and so he will be physically dead. Drugs are not proper. It really doesn't help the man in any, you know, makes it worse. You're a poor person here, you have a very expensive habit. In fact, you're living like a rich person. Because here you're giving yourself something which is going to cost you quite a few dollars per day. And where's the money going to come from? No one's going to give you that much money a day. And as your habit grows, in other words, as you use more and more drugs, this is inevitable. It's going to happen that you need more money. And no one's going to give you that as a gift.
No one is going to be sorry for you and give you money just to give you money because you will go sick, because your habit is coming down and you're going to have to get the money somehow, so you're going to steal. There's no future for him. You know, as it stands, reality, there is no present because he's really non-existent.
His whole world consists of him.
Exactly what he's doing. What if the enemy had to change his prison view that he has of himself? If he doesn't, he will remain a walking corpse.
Until this thing happens, he will continue his path nowhere. It's a day in the death of Danny Beat. Can't see the blue sky above. Can't feel the raindrops. Can't feel the sun.
Just another weary work day. In the death of Danny Beat. When you come to court, you see people standing before the law. You can realize, gee, I remember seeing that person walking around, you know, a neighbor, a few months ago. And they must have seen all the addicts and people hanging on the streets, people without clothes and shelter because you drove them. But that didn't seem to impress their minds. They probably were saying to themselves, well, that will never happen to me. I'm starting to do drugs, but I know I won't be like that. I'm not that old and young and I can take care of it. Control my habit, all this kind of thing, you know. Most of the people, real rest, my people, street vandalism, 18, 19-year-old person, what is this, junk? You just 4 to 5, 8, 10 bags a day.
Rest them for the narcotics itself, or putting them in your crime, to get money to type that habit, and then spend them anyway from 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 cents.
It's kind of hard to see a young person almost near death, because he's stuck on needles, a person who has a lot of life in him, who should be going to school, who should be playing basketball or something, and has a body to do these things. This has happened time after time. Seeing teenagers almost dying, fighting death. Many people standing around the crowd, you know, and watching this person, they see this kind of thing. There's nothing more simple before. This is a different kind of death. He's sleepy, his nose is running, he itches. He feels cold, he feels hot. He doesn't even know what the sun really looks like. He's literally living in a world of illusion. He's like a zombie.
A way of living for Danny Beat. Job and friends, or a buck. Nothing else matters. Nobody cares. Hang around to raise a little bread for the death of Danny Beat.
The great book of junkies are still the same as I left them at 25 years ago while I was in the streets, but they take me to arrest, and to the same followers who've been in jail often and often and often and the same owners, the same thinking survivors, same brutal doctors and their friends that have died of overdoses or just being sick from junk, and they're still the same part, nothing has changed for them. But most of them I know 20 years ago, I was dead or in jail. I found better things to do. I saw that wasn't me. I wanted to be a whole man. Real man. It's hard to describe. It's just really a way of killing yourself.
No more school, no more future. It's an invisible end. And I tell you, I'm not trying to put any kids down. or any people down, but start with junk. It puts you down.
It's the needle and bang for Danny. Freeze as a muscle and brain.
So it's a pretty rough story. There's no easy way to tell a guy, don't take it because he gets jaundice, because he gets syphilis, because he dies. No, he doesn't know. He doesn't know that when I see them in the autopsy room on Monday morning, see this fish-eyed look looking up the ceiling, see the end of the road, and then you gotta call the old lady, his mother, and tell her to pick up the brown paper bag up front and take all those clothes. That's the end of the road for a boy. And then she says, why?
Goodbye, Donnie. You're feeling no pain. Messing up your life. Let me land pain. Just another dirty gray dawn in the death of Danny B.
Say goodbye, people, Donnie. You're going away soon. Goodbye, Donnie.